Well, you know, like it or not, the burden for saving for retirement, it's on our shoulders. And generally speaking, many Americans are just financially unprepared for their golden years. So are you on track? Dan Amen joins us right now to help you find out. So how much money do people have right now in their retirement savings?
Well, they're doing better thanks in part to hard work and savings, but also to a cooperating investment market. We've had great returns in the stock market. But there was a study done out using Fidelity retirement plan data on the participants in their plans, which are by the millions. And the average participant, age 20 to 29, has about $11,500. Doesn't sound like a lot, but it's a good start for a young worker. Conversely, those age 60 to 69 have an average of about $193,000. So we're making progress, but it's still below what most people will need to try to replace their lifestyle at some point in retirement.
Right, so that's not enough.
It's not enough.
And so what are people contributing at different ages?
Generally speaking, you should target from the very beginning of your career, even before, try to save 10% at least of what you make each and every year. Pretend it doesn't exist. Put it away, ideally in a tax shelter retirement plan of some sort. But the average contribution rates, 20 to 29 year olds, 6.8%. Over 11% for those aged 60 to 69.
Wow.
So we are seeing the gravitation in people depending on their 401k, especially given the fact that pension plans have been on the decline and very few people have those available.
All right, and you had some stats that blew my mind, and this is the target nest age dollars or nest egg dollars by age. So give us some of those numbers about what percent of your income you should be looking to have.
Well, and that's what we just talked about is the percent of income, but what you want in your nest egg. Many people say, well, what's the number I need? And this is a guide by Fidelity, but it's a good start. By 30, try to have one times a multiple equal to your salary. So if you make $50,000, try to have $50,000 in your 401k by the time you're 30. And for those further on in their career, say 67, you're approaching retirement, you want to have 10 times your income at least in your retirement savings. So it's a big number,
yeah.
It's daunting, but it's the reality many of us need to just try to wrap and adjust our lifestyle to fit a reduced income to ensure we're saving and making it a priority.
Yeah, one of the numbers I thought I saw in there too was three times by the age of 40. And
right.
I'm thinking there's probably a lot of people at home saying, that's not realistic, I can't do that.
Right. And that is the unfortunate reality for many families trying to juggle the strains and financial strains of running a family day to day. It's difficult, I get that. But try to make it a priority to do what you can, to improve, if you can, the level of savings that you have, and do so in a manner that's tax efficient.
That's a great reality check for people about what they need. And you're saying, again, don't forget to match. Don't leave that free money on the table.
Right. And I think the greatest motivator may be the fear of what retirement will be like if you don't give some consideration to it today.
Absolutely. Never too late to start. Dan, thank you very much for that advice. Great information. Let's head over now to Alicia.